Hey guys, it's Renee. So for the snails, I'm going to be using the snails. I think these are like tips to just glue in your nails and then go ahead with an acrylic manicure. I'm not going to be doing that. I just bought them to use them as press-ons. And I bought this type as opposed to press-ons because I like how long they are. But since they are supposed to be like for the tip of your nails, they're kind of square. I'm going to be filing them to just make them round to just fit my nail, or you know, you can start with long press-on nails. Once I have done that, I'm going to be using my clippers to just cut the two edges to make this stiletto nails until they almost look like a UB upside down. And then I'm going to be guiding myself from one to just cut the next, placing this like this on top and then just cutting the other one. I'm going to be working on the shape of it, filing, just getting rid of like the pointy part that I just cut it, pretty much just making a straight line from like the bottom of the nail to just like the top, and then just working on the tip of the nail because we want them pointy but not like weapons. So yeah, I'm just going to be making that pointy part rounder until we have them like this. So I'm going to be gluing my nails just after I'm done with the shape that I want, because if I glue them, work on the shape, and turns out I don't like the shape, it's going to be so damaging on the nails and just so annoying to start all over again. So just work on the shape and then just glue them. Using glue that is for nails, I was in the past using like whatever glue, like super glue, and it's so damaging on the nails. So just stick to glues that are for nails. This one that I'm using is like from a kit. Then I'm going to be experimenting with jelly sandwich nails. And I wanted to do this because I have this nail polish, like regular one, black one, that I just bought and made a review on that I really like. It's by Wet n Wild. I changed the bottle, by the way. This is not the bottle that comes in. And later on, I'm going to show you how I clean the bottle and how I transfer one nail polish to another bottle. And you can stop right here. This is what they look like right now. I think they look really cute, shiny, and amazing. But I'm going to be making the matte. I bought this gelish matte top coat and I want to shake it out. I got it at Sally and I wanted to try it and see if it's matte. Not that I limit my matte nails just for Halloween though, I just use them all year round. I'm just shaking this out now. But to make this gelish sandwich work though, you have to make sure that your nail polish is dry. The drier they are, the more this is gonna work. I've done this before where I didn't wait and it didn't work out. I'm not really sure if I could call it sandwich though, because I didn't add a gel base coat. It's because I'm working with press-ons or just fake nails. It doesn't here to apply over gel polish. And so first I'm going to be using a coat of this gel top coat. Cure it for 30 seconds. Then go with my matte top coat. And then cure it again for 30 seconds. So you have to go with your cleanser. I'm using my lint-free wipes. I recently made a review on this one, and I'm just going to be removing the sticky layer on top. And as far as for this top coat, once you remove like the sticky layer, they are matte, but they don't stay matte for long. Like, this is not a matte top coat. I would call it this a satin top coat. I mean, I like it. It's a beautiful satin, just not matte. Kind of like disappointed, because for some reason I thought from this brand it was going to be like matte, but I'm probably not going to be purchasing it again just because I'm looking for a matte. I really like the gelish sandwich method because I have more regular nail polishes, so this gives me more alternatives. And yeah, I really like how they turn out for Halloween. A lot of people use this shape and I really like it. Doesn't work for me personally. It's just too pointy. I just stabbed myself like 3 times trying to do stuff. Neither does the length. This is just too long for me. I couldn't function with these nails. Maybe I'm not used to it, I don't know. Hopefully I'm not coming across as judgmental. This is just personal preference and this kind of nails don't work for me, but I really like them for Halloween. They are so editorial, that's for sure. But if you're on the same page, you can always like stick them as opposed to glue them. So that way you just rock them for Halloween and just remove them the next day. Or if you're cool with the shape and length, I hope this gave you ideas. I really hope you like them and you found this helpful. But yeah, it was so much fun to create these nails and I really liked them. Hopefully you liked them too. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and let me know down below. Check out more nail care that I have on my channel, subscribe for more, and share this. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you later and take care. Bye!